Hey there, welcome back to another video all about what it's like to buy, sell, move to, and live in Raleigh, North Carolina. And moving here is really gonna be the focus of the video today. This is our story about why we moved to Raleigh, North Carolina, what that process was, what we've liked about living here for the past 3 years, and even some of the things that we haven't necessarily liked as much. So come along with me as I walk you through our journey. If you don't know me, my name is Matt Martin, and I'm a Raleigh-based realtor. I've been in real estate since 2017 and since 2021 here in Raleigh, North Carolina, and I've helped tons of clients relocate here. Because I'm a transplant, it gives me a unique perspective when helping others who are looking to move here and to help them understand what it's like for someone who's not from here to relocate to the Triangle region. So, starting from the beginning, I'm originally from Southern California and lived there until a couple years after college. Then I spent 15 years in New York City. And anytime anyone hears me say that, they always ask, how did you end up in Raleigh, North Carolina? And it was definitely a little bit of a circuitous path, but after living in New York for 15 years, I knew I wanted something different. I just wasn't taking advantage of all the things that I was paying so much money for. And we wanted somewhere that was slower paced, but still had a lot of the culture, good food, access to the beach. We used to go to the beach all the time in New York City. We wanted a backyard for our dog. We wanted to be able to afford a house. We wanted a car. So there were a lot of things on our wish list. And actually, we were pretty set on moving to Denver, Colorado originally, but then we went there 1 year in October and it had just snowed. And our Uber driver told us, oh yeah, this happens all the time. And last year it snowed until June. And that was it for us. After that, we said, absolutely not. We need somewhere with a shorter winter since we were sick of all the snow and the cold in New York City. So my partner actually kept seeing Raleigh show up on all these lists, the best places to live, fastest growing cities, and he threw it out to me one day, and I said, absolutely not. I actually think there were probably some other words in there that I can't say on this video, but this LA New York City guy is not moving to the South. And to be fair, I hadn't really ever been to the South, and I was basing my reaction on a stereotype in my mind about what it meant to live in the South. But Raleigh kept popping back up, and there's something here called the Parade of Homes, which I definitely suggest you check out if you're considering Raleigh. The Parade of Homes takes place every year in October for 3 consecutive weekends, and builders open up their new construction homes so that you can get a sneak peek at what's new in the residential real estate market. So I said, look, let's go down there for the Parade of Homes. Best case scenario, we'll like it. Worst case scenario, we'll get to see some cool houses and then we'll never talk about Raleigh again. And we came down here in October of 2019. It was the hottest October they'd ever had on record. It actually hit 100 degrees while we were here, and yet we still loved it. We just loved that everywhere we went, the people were super friendly. Every meal we ate was delicious. Driving around the city, everything was so green and beautiful. It just gave us that sense of peace that we'd been looking for. So, of course, that wasn't our only trip here. And this is where I really suggest to people that you go multiple times to any city you're considering moving to if you have that luxury. You want to see it at different times of the year. Make sure you understand what it's really like to live there. Explore different neighborhoods, see what it's all about. We came back in the winter and we came back in the fall. And we always discovered something new, unique, and beautiful about the city. And during those trips, we'd always rent a car, and then we would just drive around a lot. We'd do research online or find hotspots on Yelp, and we'd go explore them. And then we'd talk to shop owners and ask some of their favorite things to do. And then we'd just drive and explore and traverse different neighborhoods and learn the geography. And we'd see different architecture. And we kind of decided for ourselves what areas and neighborhoods we liked. So if you decide to explore Raleigh for the first time, I suggest that you plan a trip for 4 or 5 days if you can. Get in touch with me and I'm happy to be your substitute for Yelp or Google and give you some of those hotspots and guidance on where you should go. But I think the best way to learn the city is to spend the first couple of days just driving around yourself and exploring. Once you've done that and kind of have an idea of what you like and what you don't like, then it's a great time for us to meet up and do some more focused exploring, including getting in to see homes, which is always the fun part. And that's exactly how we did it, both in Denver and in Raleigh. And it helped us so much to already have a bit of a feel of the city before seeing properties. So in February of 2021, we finally decided to pull the trigger and move down here. And I can say we've never looked back. I felt like we'd have some level of, oh my God, what have we done? But it's never happened. We've been back to New York City a few times. It's fun to visit. And of course, there are things I miss. There are certain things I miss even about California, even though I haven't lived there in nearly 20 years. But I think we've made such a great choice for us and our family in moving down here. So now that we've been here for 3 years, what do we really like and what do we not like so much? Well, first off, I just love how nice the people are. I mean, everywhere you go, people want to have conversations, people are smiling. In my line of work, I have to call and speak with city officials often, and they are so nice and so helpful. This is completely different than what you would experience in New York City, so that's been a breath of fresh air. We also love all the food here. We have multiple James Beard Award-winning and nominated chefs, so we have some top-tier culinary talent here in Raleigh, and they're always opening more restaurants, which brings me to the next thing I really like, which is that it's just growing a lot. It's fun to be part of a city that you can actually watch change so quickly. And I know that's a con to some people, but I love seeing the city grow and change and introduce new concepts and entertainment and food options all the time. We love the access to the outdoors, and I've talked about this in so many of my videos, but we're 2 hours to the beach, 3 hours to the mountains, and those are great. But more locally, you can go 15 minutes by car and hit a lake or hiking trail, or you can explore the Greenway all throughout Raleigh. There are trees everywhere, and it's just really easy to get out and explore. So this one might not be a pro to a lot of people, but actually, I like that we are politically diverse here. You will find a variety of opinions, but you'll also find that people don't really talk about politics a lot. So I enjoy that you can actually be friends with someone on the other side or have a conversation if that person is willing to about something that maybe you don't agree with. It's also nice living in a state where your vote counts, since we truly are a purple state. Sometimes we go red, sometimes we go blue. So it's been a new experience to actually feel like voting matters. Another thing we really like is the weather. It is the beginning of February right now, and it's about 60 degrees outside. Granted, the past few days it's been in the 30s, but to have these warmer days in the winter and to have this truncated winter has been really, really nice. But it's also nice that we still have a winter. You know, we didn't in California, so I appreciate that we still get a taste of it, but it doesn't last very long like it did in New York. And we get breaks during winter with these nice warm days. So some of the things we haven't liked so much. First up, the drivers. They're just not good here. North Carolina was just ranked the 5th worst drivers in the country, and I definitely agree with that. I think it's because Raleigh used to be a bit of a slower paced city, and now we're getting an influx of people from other parts of the country who are a bit more aggressive drivers, so the two don't always mix well. And on that same sort of subject, we have no public transportation. I mean, yeah, we have some buses, but I would really like a light rail or more train options that would connect us to Durham and to some of the surrounding areas. It would make it a lot easier to explore all the Triangle has to offer without relying on our cars all the time. Another thing, and I think this is probably true almost anywhere you move, it's not really a con, but more of an adjustment. I'm clearly not Southern, and while everyone is so nice and friendly, you can feel like a bit of an outsider sometimes, or a bit disconnected from that part of the culture if you're not Southern. There's just certain things that I didn't grow up with and that have been an adjustment for me. All right, the last thing, even though I talked about how great the weather is, and it usually is, there are those 2 months of summer that are just brutally hot and humid. The same was true in New York and in a lot of the rest of the country. It got crazy hot there, and we also had to rely on window AC units to keep us cool. So having central air here during the summer is great, but I'm not gonna lie, those 2 months are pretty hot. So that's been our experience so far. There's so much more to it that I'd love to tell you in person, but I wanted to just give you a little bit of insight into what our process was to move here, why we did it, and what it's been like for us living here over the past 3 years. If you're ready to start exploring the Raleigh area of North Carolina, I would love to be your guide. You can shoot me a text, give me a call, or drop me an email. All my contact information is located below.